Hi, thank you so much for tuning in to P2P Relates as we talk about all things relationships. I'm Pat Renfro, and today, as you can see, I have a guest, and we're going to share with you what it's all about to figure out what your gift is and then what? Act on it. So, Banufshay, thank you so much for coming today. I am so excited about our conversation.
Thank you for having me, Ms. Renfro.
Banufshay was one of my students at college, and she reminded me of family, so she has a special place in my heart that she probably didn't even know she had. And when I shared my video with several people, she was one of them, and she ended up saying, hey, I got a story for you, and she knows that's right up my alley, because in our class, I always made the students have to stand up in front of the class, get brave and share a story. They could come up with anything they wanted, but they had a certain amount of time they had to speak. And so story has always been a big deal to me because I think it's important for people to know. When I thought about her story after she shared it with me about this three-part series. So for those of you who have been following, I thank you so much. If this is your first time here, I encourage you to hit the subscribe button and also click the bell. And when you click the bell, then anytime I do uploads, you'll get notifications. And of course, at the end of this, I'd love as many likes as you can give. So today we're going to finish the three-part series. We were talking about the gift. And for those of you who have been following, I really hope that you took me up on my invitation and went and checked out the song, It Ain't Yours to Throw Away, because that's what we're going to finish today. We're going to talk about how important it is that once you understand that we all came here on earth with a gift, and then you figure out, you do your work, and you begin the journey at the very least of saying, this is what I believe my gift is, then how do you implement it? Well, you got to get past all that fear and just do it. But you do it through a journey. And so Banufshay is on her journey. And I'm just going to let Banufshay share what she wants to share.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for having me this evening. I'm going to tell you all about my story and how I found my gift as a singer. So I have always been in choir. I've always loved to sing. I've loved listening to music. But I never really understood that, like, this is just my gift and this is what I'm meant to do. And I agree. I have the same philosophy that we all are put on this earth for a reason, and we all have our strengths. And if we work on our strengths, we can potentially, you know, inspire other people and use it as our career. So that's what I'm going to be telling you all about today. I've been in choir for about 7 years. I started in middle school. I've always taken music classes growing up and loved music and singing. And my senior year of high school, I made the varsity choir for my high school. And that was a really exciting moment for me. I always knew I could sing. Like, people had told me I could sing, but I just didn't feel that confidence inside myself yet. But once I made the varsity choir of my high school senior year, I was able to practice my singing and really gain my confidence. Like, there were options to audition for solo spots, and I was like a nervous wreck, so I never auditioned for solos. But I started learning to be comfortable with it, and I auditioned for an ensemble, which is a smaller group, and I started feeling more comfortable singing by myself, because in a choir, it's like everybody. You're not listening to just one voice, you're listening to the choir as a whole. And so I had so much confidence just singing as a group, but I really knew I wanted to start making a channel at some point. And if I made a channel, I would be by myself. After I graduated around June of 2019, when I graduated, I realized how much I missed choir and singing. And I never got a chance to kind of express just my style of singing and the songs that I like to sing, because, you know, in choir, they make you sing those traditional choir songs. So, you know, so I mean, I love singing and I love singing with everyone, and I realized how much I missed it. So I decided to start my YouTube channel. And I actually, before I started making any videos, I had, I think, around 50 subscribers. I don't know how, because I didn't upload anything. But so that's where I started out. And I was trying to plan out videos and how I was going to make my channel. And fast forward to like January of earlier this year, so right before the pandemic, the Grammy Awards were on TV, and I was watching them there, an award show that has to do with singers and musicians and artists. So I watched the Grammys, and there was this young woman named Billie Eilish, and she really inspired me because upon further research, she won 5 Grammys that night for one of her albums, and she was like the female artist of the year and Billboard's top 100 and everything. I was like, wow, this is amazing. And she was so young. So I was like, I did some research on her and who she was and her background. And I found out she's almost exactly the same age as me. We are like weeks apart in age. We're both 18 years old. And I was like, oh my gosh, if she can do it, you know, so can I. So that's what inspired me to, you know, put my videos out there, because I was always like afraid of what the world would have to say or what people would say. Because when there's positive feedback, there's always, you know, the few hate comments that show up. But I was like, you know what? It doesn't matter. I'm just going to do what I love and put it out there and hopefully be that inspiration for other people. So then I started my channel. I started it in March, actually, because that was spring break. So I had more chance to like make my videos and really put some effort into it. So once spring break started and college was out, I made my channel and I put my first video out there. And that was a huge moment for me because now it's like the whole world is looking at it. And I was like, oh God, you know, it's a crazy feeling, honestly. And it's the same feeling every time I upload a video, because I'm like, I don't know if anyone's going to like it or, you know, whatnot. But I put it out there and I actually got a lot of positive feedback and good comments. And I was like, oh my God, people actually, you know, like my singing. And I knew I was a good singer, but you know, there's always that self-doubt in everyone once in a while. But I got a lot of positive feedback and people were telling me to make more. I got a lot of song suggestions. And because, you know, the lockdown happened, I had a whole bunch of time. So I was focusing on my music and what songs I was going to do. And I ended up collabing on projects with people. Actually, this one girl had direct messaged me on Instagram and she was like, I love your voice. I want to collab with you. And I was like, oh my gosh, sure. So we made that happen. And that's my latest upload. But yeah, I've just been like on this incredible journey of like self-confidence kind of. It's more like I started off just like, I know I can sing, but I don't know if anyone's gonna like it. And then because of the feedback I got and because now I'm not in choir anymore, it's just me singing on YouTube. So people are getting to see like what I actually can do. And I'm really proud of myself for
that. Is so awesome. And we have it on record right now. So when you really make it big, we'll be able to go back and say, remember when?
Remember when?
That is awesome. Wow, that's a great story. And thank you so much for sharing that. That's pretty
exciting. Thank you so much for allowing me to share it. Do you have any questions for me at all?
Oh, yeah. So the first question is, beside being in the choir and of all the different interests you may have and different things that you've tried and done, what made you feel like the song was most likely your gift?
Singing was my gift because honestly, the feedback I got, even in choir, I actually got a lot of good feedback. I had friends who told me I was a really good singer when I made the varsity choir of my high school. My directors had told me that I really have something special and I could, you know, take it somewhere, and that I have good tonal memory, which means whenever they played something on the piano or something was sung, I could repeat it back on key, like on the same pitch, the same notes. So they said that was my gift. And then I decided to take that forward. And it's like, it was a big step for me because there's no musicians in my family. Nobody like has any idea how to play any instrument. I'm actually not that good at playing instruments either. I'm learning, but my singing is my, like my voice, I feel like I have a lot of control over more than any instrument. So I was like, you know, I think I'm meant to be a singer. And especially when I got so much practice and my directors were telling me, you know, this is where you can improve, this is what you have. I really took that into account and then decided to improve with that and start my channel.
When I told my story about my gifts and how I discovered them, it was much later, you starting early, and it took many different evolutions of work for me to figure out, oh, it's really helping people become the best they can be. I kind of sort of knew that, but I didn't know what frame that would take. You, on the other hand, have a similar journey to my sister. When she was 18, it was time to go to college. We were all encouraged to go to college. And she went to my parents and said, I wanted to ask if you all would support me, but I want to take 1 year off and do singing. And if it works, great, I'm on my way. If it doesn't work, I promise you I will go back to school. The only other job my sister ever had, even 40, 45 years later, is a census taker. Probably 30 years ago, she was a census taker. But other than that, the way she's eaten, the way she's lived and paid her bills and all that is through her song. And I'm telling you, she's had a fabulous career, and it was all because she dared to believe that she could. And like I said in the previous video, we have gifts that the world is waiting for. The world needs what we have in us. Now, does every single person in the world need what we have? No. But you don't know who needs it. All you know is that it's in you and it needs to come out. And it wasn't for you. It's for other people to get the advantage of. And so there's no telling how many people Banufshay is going to be able to lead and guide and encourage and influence because she made the decision to step up and step out and not just sit on her gift because it was scary.
Right. No, it was really scary. It always happens. It happens to everyone. There's like, no matter how much I feel, everyone can tell you, you know, you can do it. You're so good at it. It's like, until you set yourself in that mindset that I can do it, like, you know, you're not going to gain that confidence. It has to be like a inner thing. Like your mind has to be trained to just be like, go for it and like, believe that you can do it. Don't be like, oh my gosh, like, I don't know if I can, because that's what I was like in the beginning. But after, you just got to get yourself in that mindset that like, I can do it, and like, if I really want it bad enough, like, I'm gonna do everything in my power to achieve it.
Yeah. And if you don't get that mindset, you're right, it starts with the mind. If you can't really change your mind and say, I've got to do whatever it takes to make this happen, you won't do it. You'll make excuses. I know for me, I had to actually get some coaching before I did my first video, because I had tried it last year and it was a hot mess. And I just kept working on it until finally I was able to put it out. I was like horrified. I was like, I keep putting it off. I keep saying I'm going to do it next week. And what if I started and then I'm not consistent and blah, 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 blah. And this guy worked with me for just one session and it was phenomenal. And I've been on my way ever since. So fear can shut you down.
Like, I kept blowing off my first video too. I was like, I don't know if I want to upload it. That was kind of trash. I need to redo it.
Right.
So I'd be sitting there like, you know, redo it. Oh no, my camera angle sucks. Like, I'd change it. And then, you know, I would be like, oh no, I was flat on this note. Like, I need to do the whole song over again. So I'd sit there doing like the 3 to 4 minute song, like over and over again, just to, you know, and it was never like, I feel like you honestly will like never be satisfied with yourself, because you can always like, as yourself, you can pick out, hey, I don't like that about myself. I don't like this. I don't like how this turned out. But then like, when other people see it and you get that positive feedback, that's what like feeds your confidence. And then once you gain from that and you have like your own confidence, then, you know, it shows, and then more people will, I feel like, support you, just like when your own confidence starts to shine through, especially.
Well, actually, like, you should rejoice when you get your first thumbs down, because that means you're out there enough for somebody to be watching.
Right.
And it's inevitable. But your majorities are always going to be positive likes and to get comments too. I've seen your channel and people do comments. Really cool. It's just doing you will draw out what's supposed to happen in the right time. What are some of your plans for going forward?
So I'm still going to keep uploading on my YouTube channel. I've actually gotten an offer from someone to start making my own song, but I haven't done it yet. I'm like literally so bad at songwriting. So I definitely want to like reach out and collaborate with more people to like try to help me make my own song. But for now, I've been doing the covers and gaining a lot of subscribers, which is crazy. Like, I actually didn't think, it was more like, oh, I'm doing this for fun, we'll see where it goes. But it's actually kind of going somewhere. So it's kind of motivated me to like put some effort into it and, you know, really get it going. And hopefully just become like a YouTube sensation and not a famous singer, because I mean, right now I'm in college, of course, and I'm doing my associate of science for psychology, because I do love psychology. Once I get my associates, I want to take a year off and just focus on music like your sister did, and just see, you know, where it could go if it goes somewhere, then, you know, that's great. If not, I can always just go back to school.
Why did you pick psychology?
I think psychology is just really interesting. I love how, like, different every human being is and, like, how we think. And, like our gifts is, like, amazing. Like, everyone has a different gift. And you don't know who you're going to inspire, you know, because, like, Billy inspired me. And, you know, I could be inspiring some other little girl or something to, you know, use her gift, whether it's singing or not. Because, you know, on my channel, the same thing. Like, everybody gets positive comments, but then there are those few negative comments that, like, might be able to bring you down. But I'm like, hey, at least you noticed. At least you watched. Like, it's okay.
Yeah, you're out there. Yeah,
yeah, I'm out there. I mean, if you didn't like it, that's fine. Because there was this one YouTuber who, like, barely any subscribers. They just kept commenting a bunch of hate on, like, all my videos. Ew, this sounds bad. You can break glass with that. I was like,
oh.
Yeah, I got, like, some really negative comments, and I was like, you know, but I didn't let it get to me, because I was like, you know what, if I'm not inspiring you, it's okay. That's, like, one in a billion. Like, I can inspire other people, and there's got to be at least one person who will, like, look at the video and be like, okay, you know what, I need to work on my gift. Or whether it's singing or not, it doesn't have to be singing. They could just, you know, look at the confidence, be like, oh, I should start maybe uploading to YouTube, or focusing on, you know, my gift, whether it's singing or dancing, acting, anything. So I feel like you shouldn't let the hate get to you. That's one of the things too, because I never really let the hate get to me, but it was more like I always noticed it. And that's what the haters want. They want you to pay attention, and, like, they want to, you know, join people up so that they can all be against you. But if you're confident in yourself enough, and you know, you're like, well, I got a ton of supporters, that's all that matters, and, like, I'm doing what I love, and I know other people love it, and I'm gonna inspire someone at some point. If it's not you, that's fine.
Mm-hmm. Right, because you can't please everybody ever.
Exactly, that's one of the lessons I learned as well this past year, that you can't please everyone. So you just gotta do what you love and be yourself. Make yourself happy, and other people will support you and be happy with you.
The other question I have, or statement, is how important it is to know who you are and how that contributes to your ability to pursue your gift and then walk out your gift. Because if you know, you had to overcome a lot of doubt, self-doubt.
Yeah.
You had to, you know, even though your teacher said you had a nice voice, or your classmate said that, you still had to believe in Banufshay enough to be able to say, you know what, this is worth it, I can try.
Mm-hmm. So honestly, I feel like you're never going to reach a point where, I mean, even if you do, there's always going to be little things where you're like, I could work on that. But that's human. That's who we are. We're humans, and we're constantly improving, you know, because there's, like, variety is the spice of life. There's so many things in the world you can do, and different routes you can take. And you just honestly got to be willing to use your opportunities if they're knocking on your door. Like, you know, just go out there, put yourself out there. That's the thing I was lacking, is, like, I had the gift, but I didn't feel confident enough to put myself out there and, like, look at my options. It's like, nah, it's not going to happen. But you can't have that doubt. You have to just get into a mindset where, you know, you're like, if I do this, I can have a bunch of opportunities. But if I just sit here and kind of think about it, then, you know, it's not going to happen. So it's really about, like, you just got to take that step. I had to believe in myself, no matter how much everyone was telling me I was good. I had to believe in myself that I could do it. And I had to teach myself to be like, yeah, I can, not just be like, oh, thank you, but actually accept it and be like, yeah, that's true. And, like, I could take this forward, and anything is possible. It's a huge world. And there's so many opportunities and so many abilities and talents, even if they're not, like, even if they're underrated, you should do it. Like, you should put yourself out there with any strength that you may have, even if it's multiple. You can do multiple things, like be a singer, dancer, actor, all of the above. You can, like, make yourself stand out from the person next to you.
And I think, you know, because we're all so unique, we will stand out if we'll just do you. You know, just do you.
Yeah, just be yourself. Do what makes you happy. Mm-hmm. It'll make other people happy, especially if you're feeling yourself, other people are going to be feeling you too.
And sometimes when people hear that, I think they think we're talking about being self-absorbed, and that's not it either. You know?
Yeah, that's not it. There's a solid difference between the confidence you have in yourself and being, like, overconfident. There's no reason to, like, you know, be overconfident and put other people down. You just have to accept that, you know, we're all different and, you know, these are my strengths. They might not be your strengths. Because I was trying to get my little cousin into choir. I was like, oh my gosh, I love choir and choir is so much fun. You should totally try it. Mm-hmm. But she did it and she was like, I don't think it's my thing. I'm more of like a theater person. And I was like, okay, you know, go for it. It was like weird at first. I was like, you know, why? Because when I found out that, you know, singing was my gift, I didn't think of it as like, it's my gift and I'm good at it. I just thought, you know, everyone has it, whatever. Like, I didn't understand, you know, that it's actually just my thing and that mm-hmm. I'm supposed to be great. Once you find what you're good at, your strengths, your gift, whatever you want to call it, then, mm-hmm. you know, that's when you stand out for yourself. And then mm-hmm. in your mind, you're like, this is me. This is what I like to do. And, you know, then people will come after you and support you.
There's actually a Bible verse that says, your gift shall make room for you. So that goes with what you said. That people will come after you, not because you're doing it for people to come after you, but when you're doing the thing that you've been deposited on this earth for, that you've been gifted to do, and you've really worked on it, because, you know, again, I tell people, don't think just because you have that gift that you can just, it'll just come out of you and it's no effort. No, you still got to develop it.
Exactly. Once I started getting the confidence in myself, I felt like then, you know, I didn't mind if people were like, can you sing for me? Because it started, like, I started feeling like, yeah, of course I can do it. But, you know, it is really just a mental thing. That's the best way I can put it. You just got to train yourself to, like, to love yourself. And that's, like, really hard sometimes, especially when, you know, different environments and stuff. Like, I'm an only child, so I don't have any siblings to be compared to. So the pressure is all on me. Like, can you be the good example for, you know, all your cousins? I have like 12 cousins and they're like all younger than me. So it's like, you know, the pressure's on me to be the best I can. So it's like everyone's different. Everyone comes from a different background, different, you know, situation. It's just like, can you take what you have and like make the best out of it?
If you do go into the arts, you go into the music industry and you become a performer, it can be really, really intense and hectic. And I would imagine even today, it'll be have a different intensity because 20, 30, 40 years ago, you put out records or eventually CDs and people could buy your CDs and that's how you would make money. But today, everything you do is on Spotify, YouTube, and Apple or whatever. And it's out there already, unless you do some things or you produce yourself and you block your music and make people pay for it. So the way musicians typically make their money is through concerts. And once you have become successful, you can travel, you can be required to travel thousands and thousands of hours and miles, and it can be draining and exhausting. And near the end of the Nashville season, they had a particular music artist that was dating the cast star's daughter. And she was a singer too. She became a singer. She was 18, 19 years old and her voice was really awesome. And today in real life, she records and her voice is just amazing. But in this story, the guy she was dating was a mega star and he couldn't go to the store without being just, you know, completely trampled or completely pursued. He had no private life whatsoever. So there are pros and cons. And I just wanted to leave this tip for those who are thinking about music as their pursuit. Just make sure you are surrounding yourself with people you know care about you, people that love you, independent of your money and your success and your fame and your glory. Because those are the people who are going to have eyes out for you to protect you and guard you so that you don't get exploited. Because it's really easy to happen. I was proud of my sister because in all those years, I don't know every journey she had, every step she took or whatever, but I know that she had a lot of people around her, and she had a lot of wisdom herself. She was a very strong woman, so she was able to keep things under control, but it's just really important to not be exploited. And the only way you can make sure that happens, besides building your self-awareness and your self-esteem, is to have people around you who have your better interests at heart. But yeah, but the point of bringing up that song, It Ain't Yours to Throw Away, and it'll be located down below as well, was to say that sometimes we're so afraid. Fear can get in the way and it can cause us to say, that's okay. This is too much trouble. This is scary. This is risky. I'm not going to go for it. And yeah. Song talked about, what if God gave you that gift? And if he did, do you have the right to sit on it? Do you have the right to just say, I'm going to disregard it. It's too much trouble.
Because he could have given it to anyone else, but you know, he chose you. And, you know, if you don't, it takes a while. It doesn't always come easy. But once you do, if you really, like, motivate yourself and dedicate yourself to that gift, I feel like you can take it, you know, wherever your heart, you just got to follow your heart. Take your gift and make it special. Make it your own. Make it kind of known to the world as, like, this is what I was given. And I want to share it with you all and maybe inspire people. And that's the best part. Like you said, the traveling and the, like, it's really exhausting. And like my mom was telling me, you know, are you sure you really want to do this? Because you're going to be traveling all over the place. You're probably never going to be home. It's going to be exhausting. Your voice will get worn out. I was like, I know. But like, honestly, it's like I said, it's not meant for everyone. But I feel like it's really meant for me. And I can do it if I put my heart and soul into it. Because like, to me, the most rewarding part about all of that is I'm doing what I love. I love to sing. I love listening to music. I love singing. And I love hearing, like, when I hear music, I'm like, wow, this song is amazing. And this artist has really inspired me. Because, you know, they went out there and put a song out thinking someone out there is going to love it. Someone's going to connect with it in a way, you know, that other people might not. So I just want to be that inspiration for other people, especially now in quarantine. It's like, we're literally just not doing anything. We're chilling at home. I have a gift. Why am I not doing anything with it? So I decided to make my channel. You know, it's kind of a break for me because, you know, after a huge long essay, maybe I do kind of want to sing a song or listen to music. I know other people might want to as well because things balance out. Along with the work, there's also the creativity. If you're working extremely hard, you might want to take a break and use your gift.
Well, I want to end this by getting a treat from you. So I have asked Banufshay if she would perform one of her songs. And so she's going to do that for us. What's the name of your channel?
Banufshay. It's my name. It's spelled Banufshay.
Okay.
I'm going to be singing and playing, actually, a song called My Future by Billie Eilish. And this song clicks with me because, first of all, it's called My Future. And in the whole song, if you listen to the lyrics, she's talking about how, you know, the future is bright if you only step into it and you go into it. There always is a future. Whether you're having a tough time right now, don't forget there is a future and things can get better. So that's what I'm going to be singing.
Right.
I love this song a lot. It came out, I think, around July. And it's actually on my channel too. I've recorded myself singing it. It's on my channel. But when it first came out, it took me about a week or so just to learn the melodies and everything and get the song down. But just recently, I learned how to play the keys on the keyboard as well.
Okay, very good. Beat,
combining both and singing it for you all today.
I can't seem to focus and you don't seem to notice I'm not here. I'm just a mirror. You can't seem to focus, and you don't seem to notice I'm not here. I'm just a mirror. You check your complexion to find your reflections all alone. I had to go. Can't you hear me? I'm not coming home. Do you understand? I've changed my plans, 'cause I'm in love with my future. Can't wait to meet her, and I'm in love, but not with anybody else. Just wanna get to know myself. I know supposedly I'm only now. No, I'm supposed to be unhappy without someone. But aren't I someone? Aren't I someone? Yeah, I'd like to be your answer, 'cause you're so handsome. So, but I know better than to drive you home, 'cause you'd invite me in and I'd be yours again. But I'm in with my future, and you don't know her. Ooh. And I'm in love, but not with anybody here. I'll see you in a couple years.
I love it.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. I enjoyed that.
Of course. I'm so happy you did. I love this one so much, because it just talks about, like, my future's ahead of me. You know, nobody knows about my future. I don't even know about my future, but hey, it's ahead of me, and that's something to look forward to.
Two points I wanted to make. One is, for those of you who know that you're not artistic in any way, don't let that be a slight. Don't feel like, oh man, well, I don't do any of that kind of stuff.
Absolutely not. Gift is just something you're good at. It doesn't have to be like creative. You can be a really amazing scientist. Go for that. If you are a really great scientist and you feel like you can be a doctor, then go be a doctor. It doesn't have to be like anything in the fine arts. It can be anything. The possibilities are endless.
Yeah, my husband was a phenomenal mathematician. Oh my God. I used to wonder why he didn't pursue a career in education where he could teach math at the collegial level, because he was really, really good. I mean, I'd be doing figures and trying to figure stuff out, and before I could get it on the calculator, he'd say, oh, so that's da-da-da-da-da-da. And he just was like that. But he was an IT guy, and he would really love computers, and he could fix anybody's computer. My daughter, she's in public health. She's just really, really, really good. She's got lots of gifts, but one of them is just really understanding the science and the medical industry and disease and all that kind of stuff. So, you know what? It takes all of us and our gifts to make the world go round. And absolutely, everything that we're able to relax in, you name it, is because God gifted people with all these different abilities, and certain people, some people step up and step out and really pursue those things, and it's to our advantage. And so I wanted to say that, and I think it was one more thing. Justin Bieber. That was the guy that
Justin Bieber, right?
When on Nashville. The girl was dating him, and he couldn't go anywhere without, you know, it's like, oh my goodness. So whom much is given, much is required. I mean, man, if you blow up, you know, you got to figure out all these creative ways to have your own life, because, man, if you're not careful.
And I'm glad you brought him up, because I remember his first song has like the most, it's like the most disliked video on YouTube.
Wow, like the first, really?
Yeah. And he, I think he was about maybe like 13-ish when he put it out there. It's the song Baby by Justin Bieber, his very first song. And like no one liked it, but you know, look where he is today. So you can't let like, you can't let like setbacks like that stop you from, and like bring you back into that self-doubt. Like, oh, maybe they're right. Like, it's like you can't let those things take you back to the, you know, oh, I'm not worth it anymore. It's right. Those things that I feel like should do the opposite. They should make you stronger and be like, you know what, it's okay if you didn't like it, but there's like several other people that like it. I know I'm confident in myself, I love what I do. And you know, he didn't let that stop him. He created more songs, and like those other songs, you know, blew up. So it's like, if he had stopped there, you know, he wouldn't be as successful as he is today. He made other songs, and like that's what I'm trying to tell myself when I create my first song. No one's gonna like it, it's fine, but there might be other songs I'll create that other people will like. And it's, you just don't know, so many opportunities, and you never know what can happen.
The second point I was gonna make is that while Banufshay figured hers out by the time she was 18, we're not gonna talk about how old I am, but it took me many, many, many years to figure out how my interests would culminate into something that was going to be useful to the world. And here I am. And I remember many years ago, my uncle, he worked for NASA, and he was he had gotten his doctorate, and he was working in the education department at NASA. And I was apologizing for not figuring out what I was going to be when I grew up. And he said, you know, sometimes you don't know that. You may not know it at 30 or 35 or 40, you know, it's okay. There's not some magical date where you're supposed to know, but you should take your experiences, your interests, your talents, your successes, and kind of put them in a precious little box and really look at what direction is taking you in. And I just want to encourage people who really don't know to realize that your journey matters. Your every day, your every week, your every year matters, and adds significant things. And they don't have to be phenomenal. They can just be something that significantly touched your heart. But as you have experiences, you want to put those together, and over time, it'll make sense. So I want to encourage you all to listen to the other two parts. I couldn't have told you 20, 30 years ago that that's what this was going to end up being, but this is definitely the work that I should be doing. And so I just want to encourage people out there that are listening, never give up on your dream, never believe you don't have one, never get discouraged and think, oh, forget it, you know, I haven't figured it out and I can't figure it out. No, it's in you.
Yeah, exactly.
It's a matter of you tapping into it and just making those efforts. And Banufshay even told you, she was in school when she was encouraged to join the choir. And as she was in the choir, the teacher was telling her, you got something special here. And it's more than just the choir. And she listened to those people around her. You've got people around you. You've got family, friends, instructors. You've got all types of people around you who see the real you in your natural habitat, your natural form, who can tell you some things that you just naturally do. That they, you know, you may not think is anything or may not think anything significant about it, but it could change other people's lives. So just want to encourage you to start that journey. Look at parts 1, 2, and 3. Check out Banufshay on her channel when you want to get really blessed with some good music just to listen to and vibe with. And
thank you.
Banufshay, thank you so much for being on the channel. I sure appreciated it, and I'm sure other people are getting the benefit of it.
Thank you so much for having me and reaching out to me to talk about my story. I had a wonderful time talking about it. I hope I inspired people to chase after your dreams and just follow your heart.
So okay. Hit the subscribe button, click the bell so that you can get notifications when I upload the video, and give me a like and tell other people about it. You all take care. Bye.
Bye.